I find it really, really special to come be invited to experience Peace in the Park. I haven't been here before. And it's like coming home. It's quite incredible. Looking over my journey of my life to come to this point, it's amazing how I've been guided little by little, little hints, little nudges, big bangs. To get here, and it's like coming home. It's just remarkable. As a child, I always played with my imagination up with the clouds and climbed the trees and thought I was a bird, and I had dreams. They were very, very ordinary dreams for many of us. I dreamt of being a model, being an actress. Those things did happen. And most of all, I dreamt of Prince Charming. I was certain that that was going to happen. And it did happen. It was remarkable. It was love at first sight, backstage, at a rock and roll concert of Pink Floyd. The lead guitarist came up to me. Apparently, he was quite shy. And they were amazed how he and his big blue eyes came up to me and said, "Hi, I'm David." And the next thing you know, within 3 days, I left my lead role in a film, I left my shots, and I went on the road. Never dreamt that part of the scenario of Prince Charming coming on a white charger would be in a limousine on the road around America. And then wind up in England. Their music inspired me so much as it came across the stage and united us all. And I later on often wondered, why does that happen? Why can we as a people be touched? What is it that touches us to be one together, not just from music, but in art and in poetry, and in the way that we smile at each other? I have to say thank you to those days. And then a very big crisis came into my biggest dream of Prince Charming, and I found myself sitting on the edge of the Thames, ready to stop living, because I didn't think there was anything beyond that love. And then my children, I heard them laughing in the garden. They were home from school, and I just went into automatic pilot. And they saved me at that moment. And that particular crisis opened me to something far greater as love. I discovered through my questioning for help, what am I here for? What do I do? How do I inspire my children when they wonder, where is Daddy? We bought a dog. We bought two dogs, and they played together and wound up making a dog. So it opened our hearts. And then I was working very closely with a mental color therapist, wonderful healer, Lily Kornberg, in the art of mental color therapy, where the colors that we are, that life is on a finer level, is within our thoughts. Every thought that you have is a color. And you can decide what palette that you want to walk in. That was the beginning of my journey to see how color and creativity is a path to your higher self. Every one of you is given a gift of beauty, of peace, of kindness, of compassion, of wisdom, it's yours. You don't have, you are complete. You don't have to try. You just have to be. I mean, this is all really new to me. I was rock and roll. I was, you know, late nights, drugs and alcohol and happy parties. And so, but I had a very fine compassion inside me that took me a long time to honor and protect, support, develop, know that it was the key to harmony and joy in my life, to share my heart so I could be here today, that I could make that artwork, that when you see it, it's a doorway to you, because you complete that work. You have no idea when you look at my work that it's you you're seeing. There's several things Cecil Collins taught me in my art class. And the first thing was that a great work of art is a mastery of technique and craft. But a masterpiece is a gift from God. And the highest responsibility that an artist could have is that you create a doorway, that you set yourself aside so that it can happen, that love can arise from the divine. I saw a movie once about an elder African-American mama who was dying in the hospital. And her last words to her visiting son was, "Please, please, use the gift God gave you." And I looked at my life and I saw that it was my art, and I was the soul of the artist, and I wanted to open the doorway, be a messenger of beauty, which is one of the bridge qualities, one of the virtues we all have, to discover and to live. So when you come and look at my art, there's one little technique I can tell you about, that there's some places there's this edge of a fine line, very descriptive. And what that means, that's the highest masculine principle. The masculine principle, ideally, in the teachings that I have been given, is that it helps to bring heaven to earth and make it visible. So the form the masculine principle makes is very, very important, because it needs to protect and support and make it possible that the feminine quality that comes, it's the bridge for God to travel through, to then meet in harmony the masculine on earth. So the very fine line is the masculine principle symbolically in my work. You'll find a flow. Equally, you'll find perhaps two defined lines or two flowing lines that run parallel to each other and dissolve into each other. And you know what you're going to do, whether you know it or not. You'll join that line. And to join the line, you're in your creative world. And the symbol, which is so important, what you look at, what you contemplate, is the image. Images that you contemplate are so important to creating harmony on this planet. So when you do that, you're in your creative world, looking at an angel, or the highest quality of woman, or of relationship, or of dancing, and you've done it. You're there. So you finish my artwork. And what you're really looking at is you. And it's just a joy to see them here, to see people in front of them. And suddenly you're just all pink and smiling and soft, happy. And they definitely have come home. They love being here because the vision of this place and everybody is just so serves what they're for. So we all do it together in unity. We are one. And it's really special. The other thing that a lot of you artists who work with color might find interesting is Cecil Collins said to me that the etheric, that place, the invisible aspect of who we are beyond this physical body, is caught in the glazes. So in my paintings, between the oil colors, I will do layers of clear glazing so that the light will travel through, creating deeper optical colors. In addition, if you start seeing a lot of paintings, the colors are reflective. They reflect the light and comes, thank you, back to you. Whereas when you do the glazing, it adds another dimension, so you're going in. I use opaque colors, which is a reflective of light. It also adds the element of being on the planet in matter. Then there's translucent, and there's transparent. And then there are the glazes, so that you will be getting this feeling. So you'll have a feeling more of the totality of what we are, because we live with that all the time. We are it. But for some reason, our identification of our society is just this physical body. And you come here to learn how to work with those dimensions. My challenge is always being an empath, that I would absorb, because I would unify with people all the time, and suddenly I find they'd be in me, and I didn't know how to deal with that, because they also, people are so longing and needy, and particularly with the Floyd, as they became more famous, and the need of people for idols, for a leader and stuff came to us, we didn't have the divine conscious awareness. It would come into the house. Huge energy. As soon as they said new album, bang, they're all in the house. And I didn't know how to deal with that at first. Fortunately, I was so in love, so that I know that our love was connected to something beyond what we even understood. And I'm very grateful to it. I gave birth to four wonderful children. But then I had to learn something more. I had to learn to be married to God and do the work that I'm here to do, and to help awaken every last one of you so that you can walk in beauty. Shine. Shine on. It's been an amazing adventure. I was guided to write my memoirs. Mine. It took me a couple years to have the courage to dare to show you what journey I have been on, leaving when it came that there were no more Learjets and no more limousines and no more six holidays on a Greek island. I get one. The kids are determined that I have to take them. But I found a richness that goes so far beyond that now. And it's here. I share that with you. It also is like a journey of color, because the photographs that I have picked out, and there's an angel beside everyone, every chapter has an angel in the photograph, and it's a journey of color. So on the subliminal side, as you are going through it, the color will be taking you as well. So there's several opportunities for that doorway. I've written poems in there, and my journey, which I so enjoyed writing, apart from a few chapters, which took me a lot of courage to put down and share with you, without it being a tell-all. It's to do with every one of us having crises at times, and the challenge of returning to the lost paradise, because we each have a memory of that. We know that we are God's children, and there's a divine paradise that we're here to learn to touch once again.